the number on the mask book is old and faded. She's living in LA with my best old ex-friend Ray, a guy she said she knew well and sometimes hated. Isn't that the way they say it goes? Well, let's forget all that and give me the number if you can find it, so I can call just to tell him I'm fine and be sure. I've overcome the blow, I've learned to take it well. I only wish my words could just convince myself that it just wasn't real. But that's not the way it feels. Operator, well, could you help me place this call? I can't read the number that you just gave me. There's something in my eyes, you know it happens every time. I think about a love that I thought would save me. Well, let's forget all that and give me the number if you can find it, so I can call just to tell him I'm fine and be sure. I've overcome the blow, I've learned to take it well. I only wish my words could just convince myself that it just wasn't real. But that's not the way it feels. No, that's not the way it feels. Operator, well, let's forget about this call. There's no one there I really wanted to talk to. Thank you for your time. Oh, you've been so much more than kind. Isn't that the way they say it goes? Well, let's forget all that and give me the number if you can find it, so I can call just to tell him I'm fine and be sure. I've overcome the blow, I've learned to take it well. Words could just convince myself that it just wasn't real. That's not the way it feels.
Operator, 1971, Jim Croce. This is, I gotta admit, this is one of my all-time favorite songs, and I'm sorry that it's taken me 11 years to get around to this for Totally Guitars. This tune, part of it is, it's pretty complicated, actually. There's a lot going on, and we're gonna take a look at everything that happens in this song. Jim's parts, which pretty much follow a regular picking pattern, but I'll talk about that in just a minute. And Maury's part, which is done with a capo at the 5th fret, not exactly necessary, but it really helps for when he gets into some of the slightly strumming things. But this second guitar part that Maury added is just fabulous, and we're going to break all of that down as part of this too. And this of course, came out on this album, You Don't Mess Around With Jim. This album made such a big impression on me. It had such great tunes on it. Time in a Bottle was on it. Rapid Roy. Anyhow, Photographs and Memories. I mean, a lot of these songs just became huge, huge hits for him. And the iconic photo of Jim in the window of the outhouse of the farm they were living at in Pennsylvania in 1970 or so. Back when times were tough. So, great shot, great album, and I hope you have all of Croce's albums. He really only made 3 studio albums, but there are a lot of other outtakes and things that showed up later, some live ones and other stuff. I want to talk a little bit about a really common picking pattern he does. And then in the introduction to this, he varies it quite a bit in the studio introduction. So we're going to talk really about a little bit more of a generic way of playing a lot of it, which is just going to be keeping your right hand, top 3 fingers, the first, second, and third fingers, index, middle, and ring finger, on the top 3 strings. Index on the G string, middle on the B string, and ring on the E string. And then just keeping a pattern going that a lot of times we'd refer to as 3-3-2. It's sets of 3 eighth notes starting with a bass, another set of 3 starting with a bass, and then a set of 2 starting with a bass. So we have typically bass notes on beats 1, the and of 2, and then 4. Now, sometimes in the intro, we end up with double bass at the end. So again, I'm going to break down the intro a little bit differently than the rest of the song because he does a couple of different things in there that he doesn't really do while he's singing. It makes it a little fancier. But get this pattern down. Thumb on beat 1, your index finger on the 3rd string on the and of 1, your other 2 fingers together on the top 2 strings. So that's our first set of 3. Thumb, index, and middle and ring together. The same thing with a different bass note, the 4th string in the bass. And then the first 2 notes again, thumb and index. So now sometimes he plays the 3rd bass note the same as the 1st. Is how that would work on a G chord. And in the intro, he sometimes puts in 2 bass notes there. So we'll break that down coming up in probably in the next segment. We'll get really specific about the intro, and then we'll break down everything else that happens with this. I think I have nothing else to talk about before the song, but a lot of little things will come up as we get further on in this. Okay, coming up, a lesson on operator. Let's talk about the intro first, because it's got some really unique things in it that don't really happen again more in the singing. We're going to play the first G chord as a full bar at the 3rd fret. And again, he pretty much never plays this G barred again. And for a reason I'll get to when we talk about the 5th measure. And so at the very beginning we hear this, the 3-3-2 pattern going from the 6th string to the 3rd to the 1st and 2nd, then the 4th string, and then the 5th, followed by the same fingers, and then the 5th string as the last bass note on beat 4, except it's not the last bass note. He lets go of the whole thing, and we hear an open A in the bass. So he actually used his thumb for both the bass notes on beats 4 and. On his way to the B minor chord. Now the whole B minor goes down with the bar at the 2nd fret, and look, you know, shaped out of the A minor family. Same pattern with 2 bass notes again, the 4th string and then the 5th string, the F sharp and then the B, on the way to an A minor chord that now gets a little bit more regular, because he does play the third bass note on the same string as the 2nd bass note. And the very last note in the measure, notice, is open, because that finger's already moving to the C in the bass that we need after that. So again, what we have in those first 3 measures are the G chord, move to the C,